like to talk about white light, white heat. I mean, the normal suggestion is that the first album, Velvet Underground and Nico, was the perfect statement, really, and that White Light, White Heat represented a sort of beginning of a fraying.
The album was very much thrown together. I think most of it happened on the road. And that was at about the time that the incoherence of our thinking about where the band should go started laying claim to a lot of our time. When you go on the road and you suddenly realize the people that were opening for you 6 months ago are now on the charts and they're headlining, and you're still struggling around the country, not having the Exploding Plastic Inevitable, not having Andy Warhol, but now a road band who are having difficulty booking themselves in the kind of venues that you've been used to, and being fairly directionless and faced with all the chickens coming home to roost of a career that went off into the ozone layer for a while, but it didn't stop there. It went on and on and on beyond that into the road, which had its own debilitating effect on everybody's psychological well-being. All of that stuff ended up eating away at us, and that was part of the slow erosion of our musical camaraderie.
It is odd the way the band just sort of dissolved without any seeming reason. There were no big blow-ups, you know, no angry fights. It just, things, you know, just the center can't hold or something. People just fell off as it went along. Lou just sort of dropped off. it was very strange. And since there never was any great apocalyptic moment where we said, screw it, you know, enough is enough, no more of this, it's made it possible for us to come back, you know, just as casually to say, well, why don't we all wander together into a room that has some musical instruments and play them. Just like the last time we wandered off and left them.
Lou and John, the writers of the group, really enjoy writing together, even though they tussle and, you know, there's fights and arguments and one wants to throw the other one out the window. In the end, they really enjoy what comes out of it. And I think we've all grown up a lot, calmed down a bit, so that we're all willing to give a little more than we were when we were younger.
And in those days we were struggling to have fun. And now that we've been pleasantly surprised that the two can coexist, I think that we can get on with a lot more work. I hope we do. That was really the premise under which I really participated in this. And I hope it's borne out.
Well, in a continuum, it's a volatile brew. So we make a certain kind of music, the four of us together. And I think we all genuinely like one another and what we do. I think everybody's trying to get along, and things that could have blown it apart and did, I think everybody's being very careful not to do that right now, because we respect each other and the music enough to try to contain lunacy.
Did you need the time apart?
We needed 25 years apart.